In 2016, we built this barn with fresh air in and with a milking robot. That has been a dream for me for many years. With a new milking system, with a milking robot, I can just use half an hour a day at the robotic milker instead of 5 hours before. And that's a game changer for me.
Good afternoon, sir.
Hello, Trygve.
How is it going?
It's going quite well. My cows are quite robust and curious cow, yeah. With good health. Yeah. And in an environment like this, yeah. With good fresh air and feed all the time, yeah. They are milking good.
Right.
And the robotic milker do not need the perfect udder, yeah. But it's need a good udder. And Norwegian Red have good udders, yeah. so it's no issue.
So what about the production performance? Are you satisfied?
They are producing quite well. And we are about 10,000 liters energy corrected. And they are, we have 1.3 insemination per cow.
Wow. I mean, internationally, Norwegian Red is used in crossbreeding. And you mentioned the fertility and health. And that's really where Norwegian Red shine. Norwegian Red is superior for fertility and have a very good health. And that's, I think, is the main reasons why people are crossbreeding and consider Norwegian Red in a crossbreeding concept. If they can produce the same amount of milk as the Holstein, eat less feed, increase fertility and improve the health, then you don't need to be a rocket scientist to figure out that that's more efficient and gives you more profitability.
Yeah. That's true. Yeah, it's good. It's good animals.
Yeah. Should we go and have a look at the milking robot and look at some figures?
Yeah, if you want to do that, we can do that, yeah. Andrew.
Perfect. Yeah.
But it's very impressive. It's just milking the cow.
Yeah, yeah.
it's biologic and everything, but yeah. The robot fix it. Yeah. When the udder gets smaller after a while, yeah. It adapts to that.
Exactly. Yeah. So what are we seeing here, Ole?
Here we can see the total milk yield on the cow, what's expected and what she has milked so far. And as you see here, it's 24 days, yeah. Since she's been calving. And the average yield is 41.6 liters. Yeah. But the real data I get on the computer.
Yeah. Yeah.
This is just if I want to look after something, yeah. But in the morning I use the computer.
Yeah. It's impressive amount of data that can be utilized from the robot from a breeding perspective as well. Yeah. I mean, this is objective, precise data. And that means that the data quality is extremely good, and that will definitely contribute improving the genetic gain and our breeding work. Here we see a nice cow, Ole, 503.
Yeah, she is a beauty. It's yeah. A first calfer.
Yeah.
And as you see on the udder, it's good, yeah. And it's functioning well in the robot.
Yeah.
And the milk yield is about as the rest, 38 liters per day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Looking good.